Hello everyone. Today we will understand the database languages, and in that we will understand the data definition language. That one is the points comes under the database management system. Then database languages with the example. That one is different between the MySQL. We will go with this lecture with these 3 points. That one is different between the MySQL and the SQL. Then structural query language, SQL means what, and then SQL queries with example. Then we will understand the basic difference between the MySQL and SQL. SQL is a standard language that enable the user to design and manage the database. That is simply the SQL is a structural query language. That is a language which one is used to design and manage the databases. Means if we want to create the database, manage the database, we need some language, and that language is structural query language. On the other hand, MySQL is a relational database management system. We will understand a relational concept later, but the MySQL is a database management system. Means MySQL is a DBMS, and in that one is the SQL contains under the MySQL itself. That is the SQL is the structural query language, which one is manage or design the database. MySQL is the database management system that allows user to store and retrieve the data from the database. Okay, then MySQL uses SQL to perform specific operation on the databases. That is under the MySQL. If we install the MySQL, that is MySQL, we already installed the MySQL server, and this is the client command. With the help of this, we manage the databases, and we can say that MySQL run under, or it may be MySQL SQL run under the MySQL. That's why this sentence says that MySQL uses the SQL to perform the specific operation on the database. Then next, that one is structural query language means what? Structured query language means what? SQL is a standard language for accessing and manipulating the databases. That one is simply the use of SQL. That is the language. What is SQL? That is structured query language. SQL lets you access and manipulate the database. With the help of SQL language, we can manipulate or access the database. Then what can SQL do? Then what exact the use of SQL? SQL can execute the queries against the database. Then we will understand the different type of queries under the types of languages. SQL languages or categories like DDL, data definition language, DML, data manipulation language. Okay, then TCL, DCL. Then SQL insert the record in a database. SQL can update the record. SQL can delete the record from the database. Then create the new database. Then create new table under the database. Then create stored procedure and the database. And these are some advanced concept like a procedure and all that. That one is we will understand later. Then create a views in the database. That one is again the different type of view for the user. With the help of SQL we can create. We will understand the view concept later. Then SQL can set the permission on a table, procedure and views. That means again the we can control the user command with TCL, transaction control languages. Okay, that is actual the basic use of the, or maybe the exact use of the SQL. SQL is a structured query language. Then a rule for writing SQL queries. That means whenever we write the query under the SQL, then it's have some rule. Like when we write the code under the C programming, then it's come with a different type of C keywords. Then rules, syntax rules, like end with a sentence with a semicolon, like that. Same thing, SQL is again a language, query language. It run with some rules. Most important point to be noted here that SQL is a case insensitive. Means if we write something or we write under the SQL queries, that is for example student. If we write a student in a small letter or a capital letter, that means the same under the SQL. Okay, that's why it's a case insensitive. We will understand later with the help of different type of example. Select and select have same meaning in the SQL statement. This is simple the example, like select is a one word. If we write a select in a small also, that one is the same meaning for the select and small case in a select. All the SQL statements start with any of the keywords, like same C contains a different type of keywords, same thing SQL contains a different type of keywords. Then some keywords are select, insert, update, alter, drop, create, use, show, and all the statement end with the semicolon. Means every query under the SQL start with the keywords. Okay, everyone knows about what exact the keywords mean. Okay, then structural query languages, we already understand in a previous lecture, that one is a DDL, that is data definition language. Then or it may be we will understand SQL contains a different type of command and that command categorized into these types. Then DDL, that is data definition language. Then DQL, data query language, that means only for select query we comes mention it as a data query language, because of with the select we only select the record from database. That's why that's not comes, and normally it mentioned under the DML, but actual that one is a DQL. DML, data manipulation language. DCL, data control language. And TCL, transaction control language. In this lecture we only understand the DDL, that is a data definition language commands. Okay, in a later lecture, in a later video lecture, we will understand the other these commands. Then next, that one is a data definition language means what? I already explained about the DDL, that is a data definition language. What is mean by the data? When we create the any database, when we create any table, that's that one we can say that that schema or that definition of database or the table, that is comes under the creation of the database or the creation of a table, that comes under the data definition language. It is used to define the database structure or the pattern. It is used to create the schema, table, indexes, constraint. Okay, using the DDL statement you can create the skeleton of the database. Means if we want to create the skeleton of database, definitely the particular command comes under the data definition language. We will understand with the help of different type of example. Then data definition language DDL, that one is here are some tasks that comes under the DDL, data definition language. Create, when we create the database, that one is simply the, we will understand with the example. We will just to check the existing databases. Show, this is simply the query, show databases. It shows the existing database. Right, information schema, MySQL, performance schema, test DB. We will just to create a new database, that one is simply the create database name, that one is a MyDB. Okay, it gives a error. Okay, we need to mention the create database and then name of the database MyDB. Okay, it's mentioning with the query. Okay, one row affected, it's created the database under the server, that is MyDB. We will just to understand again or show the database. In previous it does not contain a MyDB. Now we create with the create database MyDB. Create database MyDB is a database name and it reflect here, that one is when we show databases it comes under the server. This is simply the create database. Okay, then we can create the table also. We will understand with the help of example later, like with the practical example. Then create, there are some tasks comes under the DDL, like a create database means what? we create a schema, we create a design of a database. That database name is a MyDB. Then next, that is alter. It is used to alter the structure of the database. If we create the alter, that means if we want to change the column name, or maybe we want to add, delete column name, columns, then we can say that that is alteration of a table. Okay, that is comes under the alter command. Then drop, it is used to delete the object from the database. If you want to drop this database, we can directly drop then MyDB. Okay, sorry, you need to mention the drop database MyDB. Okay, it's run the run this query, and with the help of this drop command or query, it dropped the MyDB, means it's deleted the MyDB database from the server. We will just to show it again, show the database. Now the MyDB is deleted with the help of drop command. Okay, like that. This is all the commands related to the definition about the database. That's why it comes under the data definition language. This is very important concept. What exact, why we called as a data definition language? Okay, then drop, then truncate, it is used to remove all record from the table. We will understand the drop and truncate difference, because of it's look like a similar, but not a similar. Drop, that one is used to drop the table, drop the database. Truncate, if you want to delete the record from the table, then you use a truncate command. Okay, remove the all record from the table, we use a truncate command. Then rename, it is used to rename an object. Like you need to change the table name, then you can change it. Then we want to change the database name as a MyDB, as a YourDB, we can change it with the rename. Then comment, it is used to comment on the data dictionary. Like same when we mention the comment under the C language, same thing we will use under the SQL. We will understand it. In this lecture, we only understand the create, drop and truncate with the help of this type of example. Okay, and in a later lecture, we will understand the alter, remain and comment. Okay, then we will start with the create. Then SQL create statement, that means there are the two create statement available in SQL, that is create the database and the create the table. We will run it practically, like create database, and database name is MyDB. Okay, it's a query. Okay, one row affected because of it creates a my database. Then if you want to check it, it's created or not, show MyDB is here. In this, it's not available, we create it, and now it is available, MyDB, that is the database name. Now then we want to create the table under the particular MyDB database. Okay, then create table. Table name, that one is a student. We create the student as a table. Then you need to mention the column names under it. That one is a roll number. Then you need to mention the data type. Whenever we create the code under the C, when we define the variable, definitely we define the variable data type. Same thing, roll number is a variable. Then we need to define the variable data type, that is a int. Int means an integer, and then size is 3. Then next, that one is a name with the var char, means we can add the character and number combination, or special character combination, character, number, special characters combination, which one is comes under the var char. We can mention the these three combination. If we define the variable as a varchar, the size is 20. Then again, okay, we create the two table, two columns under this. Then create. It gives the error. Why? Because of no database selected. It mentions the no database selected. Why? Because of we need to mention as use my DP. Okay. Then it actually comes under the action MyDB after creation of a database, it's not, we cannot directly access it. We need to mention as a use my db. Then we can after the use my db, the database changed, means now we can create the table under the database. Now we will create this, run this query. Okay, now it run, that is create table, our table name is a student, query is okay, zero row affected, that one is no error, that one is a process. Then we will understand this is simply the create database and create table. Then we will go through with the theory. We already run it practically, that's why it's easy to understand. Now the database is defined as an structured set of data. So the SQL very first step to store the data in a well structured manner into the created database. The create database statement is used to create a new database. That means simply we will already run it, create database, database name. Database name, name of the particular database. Example query, create database. This is simply the process. Now we will understand the create table. We have learned above about the creating a database. Now to store the data, we need to need a table to do that. Then we need to create a table. We create the table with the help of this command, create table, table name and the column name. These are the two column name. Okay, then table in a SQL. Okay, we know that the table comprises of row and rows and columns. So while creating a table, we have to provide the all information, like we provide already provides the column name here, right, as a roll number and the name. Then it's a syntax for create table. We already understand it, table create, table name as a student, and the column name, column 1 roll number, column 2 name. Okay, this is simply the syntax for that. Then what is the data type? That int is a data type and 3 is a size, means max size of roll number is a 999. Then size of a data type, that one is a 3, varchar, that is a 20, means we create the string of a 20 under the name. That is simply the data type and size. Then create a table syntax, we already created, that one is a create table, student, roll number, name. Okay, then we will understand the next concept. We already understand that one is create table, create database. Now we just to use the one query, which one is actually comes under the data manipulation language. But we want to drop or truncate, we need some record in a table. That's why I run one query, that one is insert table, table name is student, then values, means I just to create a one or insert a one record under the table, that one is this. Okay, what is the problem? That is, you have a error in your SQL syntax, check it corresponding to MySQL server version. Insert table student, insert into table name, we will check it. Okay, that one is a insert where into table name, that is a student, and then value, that is 1 and Srikan. Then this is insert is actual the data manipulation language or the command. It's not comes under the data definition language, but we want to understand the drop and truncate, we need a record under the table. That's why we need to run the insert query, but that one is comes under the DML, data manipulation. Okay, same thing, we want to select, this query is also comes under the data manipulation. Select star from student, then it shows a particular record, which one is we already inserted. This is simply the, now student table contains a one record. Now we will understand what exact the drop and truncate. Then in that we will understand what is mean by the truncate. First, truncate statement is a data definition language. Okay, it comes under the DDL operation that is used to make extent of the table for deallocation or empty for reuse. Means we store the one record in this table, that one is one and Srikant. Truncate command remove the table content or delete the table content. That one is the result of this operation, quickly removes all the data from the table. That is actually the use of truncate command. We will run it. That one is truncate table name. That one is a student. Okay, it's run properly. Truncate is command table. Then we will again select star from student. Okay, it says now empty set. Here select star from student, it shows the one record. Then we run a command, that is a query, that one is truncate table name, that one is student. This command remove this operation. If this table contains 10 records, this command remove all the records. Okay, that is actually the use of truncate. Then here I just to mention select as in a small letter, and here I mention as capital. SQL is not a case sensitive, that's why it's workable. Select in a capital and select in a small is the same thing under the SQL. Then syntax, this is simply the use of a truncate. Now we will understand the drop. That is drop is used to delete a whole database or just a table. Means if you want to delete this table, whole structure, then we use the drop, right? If we want to delete the record of the table, then we use a truncate. Then we will just check it out. That is the select star from student, that is an empty set. Now I just run the drop table name is student. Okay, it runs. Now we will check it. It gives the error. Why? Because of now the student is not available under the MyDB. Select star from student, it shows the empty student, means student table is available here. Then I run the command, that is drop table student. Then it run properly, and then again select the star from student. I just to access the student table, but it gives the error, table mydb.student does not exist. Why? Because of we drop it, means we delete it. Under the DDL data definition language, we change the skeleton of database, means with the help of drop command we change the skeleton of database, right? We delete the table, then we can drop the database also. How we can drop it? Drop, or in before that we will check it, show databases. That one is show databases. Particular database server contains a MySQL database. Now we will write a query, drop database name is a MyDB. Okay, it runs successfully. Now again we run the show the databases, then it removes the MyDB because of we run the drop command. This is simply the use of drop command under the DDL. Then truncate is used to delete the record under the table, not a table. Drop, we can delete the table itself. Okay, if you want to delete the all record and table, then you can directly use the drop. If you want to delete the database, you can directly use a drop. This is the use of drop and truncate. Now what exact difference between the drop and the truncate? Truncate is normally ultra fast, means as compared to drop, truncate is fast. It's ideal for deleting data from the temporary table. It's normally under the databases we create the temporary table, and in that case we use a truncate. Truncate preserves the structure of the table, means truncate not delete the structure of a table, it only deletes a record of a table. Okay, then unlike a drop where the table is deleted with its full structure. Drop delete the full table structure. Table or database deletion done with the drop. Statement cannot be a rollback. If we use the drop, it is not a rollback. If we use the truncate, it may be the rollback. Then what exact the rollback? If we delete it, or it, we can say that currently you understand the concept with a undo. Okay, we will detail understand it rollback concept under the next coming unit, that one is unit 5 or 6. Then queries, that is to delete the whole database. We already run these queries and we already understand how exact it work, right? This is simply the explanation about the drop and the truncate. Then this is simply the tabular format of our differences. SQL command that destroy the table structure and the data stored in it. Drop destroy the all table and the record also. Truncate, it's only a remove the record of a table. Help to remove the record of the table structure and to remove the database from the system. It remove the all table database means if you directly drop the database, then under the particular database contain the three table, then that table contains a record. With the help of drop database name, it delete the all the content. Help to remove the record from the table. Then drop table name. This is simply the command syntax. It's an explanation about the drop versus truncate. Okay, thank you.